What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. It's your boy Terabyte Reacts. We're here with some more Black Salesman. We're starting season 3 today. I'm ready to go. Just finished watching season 2 finale. It was awesome. Vane rescuing Flint. That was awesome to see them working together. And maybe now Vane can, you know, go in the same vein, spelt differently, okay? In the same vein as Captain Flint. I'm looking forward to that. But at the end of the day, if these two start working together, I think they can accomplish a lot more together than working against each other. I don't like Captain Hornigold. Don't like him. Them selling people out to get their freedom, it's not okay. Yeah, I'm saying. So him and Dufresne, man. I told you, I just didn't like Dufresne. I just don't like him. I get certain ways where they come off, but you know, sometimes when some people just think that, you know, you're getting too big for your britches. Like, we get it, dude. You're intelligent, but you're not. You know what I'm saying? Like, it was kind of like an offhand why Mr. Gates actually suggested him. You know what I'm saying? To be a quartermaster, but he's just one of those guys, man. He's just like, you're just a nerd, dude. Like, get, I'm saying, you can pretend, you know what I'm saying, you pray with them, but you can't play being a pirate, okay? You got it or you don't, you know what I'm saying? Billy's a real one, you get what I'm saying? Mr. Silver, he's real because it benefits him, you know what I'm saying? But he's learning how to be a better person, and I think he has the best character development in the show, to be honest. Mr. Silver, I think he does have the best character development out of all the characters, to watch him grow from being a thief, you know, from that, being now the quartermaster of, you know, under Flint. Great stuff. He's really stepped up as a character, in my opinion. That's all I have to say. Let's get to the episode. I will see you guys for the review. And also, if you have not signed up for early access yet, a lot of these episodes, man, that y'all are watching now on YouTube, they was on early access way back. Come on, guys. It's only $1.99 or whatever that is. It's $1.99 for in the US. $1.99. Sign up. Get early access to these episodes, man. I appreciate it. Supporting the channel, wherever you choose to do so, I'm here. I'll see you guys next time for the review. I don't know why I just said that. All right, so that was season 3, episode 1. That was really good. Like that episode. Great opener. Showing off everybody, all the characters, where they are, and they've introduced a new character, which is Teach, right? Teach is infamous. Like, most people know about Blackbeard was an actual pirate. Infamous. Stories are written about it. If you're writing anything about piracy, there's always a Blackbeard. So I don't know if they're going to call him that, but I know that he's always synonymous with the name Teach, right? That nickname, Blackbeard. So I don't know if they're going to use the nickname Blackbeard in this series, but I do know that the name Teach is always synonymous with Blackbeard. So I don't know if they're going to do that, but any case, I'm interested to see. Seems like he's an old friend of Captain Vane. I don't know how true that is, but maybe he's just looking for Captain Vane and just said, hey, I'm looking for an old friend. But he appeared. He came by himself. How good is this dude? But also showing off who Flint has become. Very cold and calculated. They're doing raids, you know, trying to put that fear out there for Nassau, so they don't even think about trying to attack the island, because they're like, oh, these dudes are crazy, we don't want none of that smoke, right? So that was pretty well done. love how they're setting up, like chill vein, you know what I'm saying? Like, he's chilled. You know, when he tells the story about, well, not really a story, but is just in reference of things that he went through as a slave, it's always like, you know, one of those moments where you really do have to like zone in and hear what he has to say, the perspective of it. And it's always really well done. You know what I'm saying? Because when you actually think about it in terms of slavery, like, he hates the idea and the whole ideal. He just doesn't like it. He just doesn't like the fact that, you know, there are people that have been slaves or what have you. So I like that. I'm sorry. I don't know why I'm yawning. I mean, I have been sitting here for a little bit, and I'm not sleepy. I don't know why I'm yawning. It could be because I'm, like, just been here sitting down for a while. I need to get up and stretch. But regardless of what's happening, you know what I'm saying? Like, the threat that they've come under. I don't know what Eleanor has planned, but anything to get out. I don't think she's going to betray the people of the island. But she gave him a name. I'm pretty sure she gave him Vane's name. Because if Vane's still alive, there's no chance of you taking that island. That man, you know what I'm saying? So now that we have, we also learned that Vane was the one that stepped in between. I would have loved to see that dynamic happen. But I don't have a problem with them skipping that whole thing and just diving back into the story of the threat that is incoming. It's like, you know, because you're going to be wondering how, you know, Flint got back to Nassau. How did Jack deal with that? What happened between him? Because we know that as soon as he got there, he was going to be like, yo, what's good? I know you got the gold, but that's our gold. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's our gold. That's what we set out to go get. You don't get to go pick that up and claim that after we out here fighting a war. You don't get to go do that. Okay? So Vane was the one that stepped in between them and kind of reasoned everything out, so they kind of shared the goal or whatever the amicable solution of this was. It happened. Okay, so we're moving on. So they need to build back the fort. Jack was slacking because it's like, but I, as I said during the scene, I understand where he's coming from. But all you gotta do is just make sure you're paying these people. That's all you gotta do. Like, if you're just letting them work just because they're slaves or whatever, that's wrong. You get what I'm saying? Like, I wouldn't even allow that to happen, no matter what. I get we're trying to protect Nassau, but for it to be built on the back of slaves, I'm not for that at all. I would have never agreed to that, point blank, period. I would have been like, at least give them something. You get what I'm saying? Not just food. Give them money. Pay them. You know what I'm saying? Help them build their homes and give them land and stuff like that on the island so they can have homes and stuff like that. You know what I mean? Because it's not about what you have. You see, everybody else on the island already know what you have, so they're going to demand more. A bunch of clowns. You know what I'm saying? And you know, what's mine is not yours. It's not like if I go to a rich guy's house and go try to work for him and be like, oh, you can afford to pay me, even though I said the job, you know what I'm saying? Like, I know he's rich. He says, I'll pay you $50 an hour. And be like, oh, you can afford way more than that. What are you trying to play? You can't do that, no matter what. Because at the end of the day, like, you're not rich. That's the point. You're not the one with the money, so take what you can get and move the hell on. That's how it's supposed to be. But you know, people are people. You know what I'm saying? They feel like Jack can afford to pay him more, but he's not. At the end of the day, they don't want to do the hard labor, so don't do it, man. You know what I'm saying? They don't care because they think they're safe. You know what I'm saying? And I think what they should do is let them know, hey, the Navy, you know what I'm saying, they set up camp not too far away. You know what I mean? So, we'll see how that goes. Anyways, guys, thank you guys so much for tuning in. As always, man, we are on the way with season 3. I'm about to go watch another episode. and to see what where they're gonna take us in episode 2 of season 3. You guys like, comment, you know what to do. Subscribe if you're new. It's your boy, Terabyte Reacts. I'm out. Peace.